year 1462. Constantinople had fallen. Muslim Turks swept into Europe with a vast superior force, striking at Romania, threatening all of Christendom. From Transylvania arose a Romanian knight of the Sacred Order of the Dragon, known as Draculia. On the eve of the battle, his bride, Elisabetta, whom he prized above all things on earth, knew that he must face an insurmountable force from which he might never return. Vengeful Turks shot an arrow into the castle, carrying false news of Draculia's death. Elisabetta, believing him dead, flung herself into the river.
Miss Lucy, why, you're as fresh as a spring rain.
Oh, thank you. Oh, Quincy, please let me touch it. It's so big.
Miss Lucy is harder than a June bride riding bareback buck naked in the middle of the Sahara.
I would watch my colonial tongue if I were you.
Hello, Jack. And how's our lovely patient today?
Well, frankly, Arthur, I'm confounded.
Oh, Jack, are you still brooding over Miss Lucy?
I can only conclude it must be something mental.
How very droll. Do you hear that, Quince? Last week he wanted to marry her. Now he wants to have her committed. Let's go and have a look at her, shall we?
I'm at a loss, I admit. I've taken the liberty of cabling Abraham von Helsing, the metaphysician philosopher.
Lucy? Lucy?
Abraham von Helsing.
Dr. Van Helsing.
You're Madam Mina, dear friend to our Lucy, yeah?
How is she, Doctor?
She's still very weak. She tells me of your beloved Jonathan Hark and your worry for him. Well, I too worry for all young lovers. Then darkness is in life, my child, and there are lights. And you are one of the lights, dear Mina, the light of all light. Go and ask your friend.
He said if you don't get better right quick, I have to put you out of your misery like a lame horse.
Quincy, you're such a beast. Will you kiss me?
Lucille, listen to me. Sleep. Sleep now. Sleep.
She lives beyond the grace of God, a wanderer in the outer darkness. She's vampire, Nosferatu. These creatures do not die like the bee after the first sting, but instead grow strong and become immortal once infected by another Nosferatu. So, my friends, we fight not one beast, but legions that go on age after age after age, feeding on the blood of the living.
Quickly, hide, hide, now!
Here's the shocking and frightening history of the wild berserker Prince Dracula. How he impaled people and roasted them, boiled their heads in a kettle, how he skinned them alive and hacked them to pieces and then drank their blood. Yeah. Dracula.
We left London by train and crossed the English Channel that night in stormy seas. No doubt from the passage of the Count's ship. He commands the winds, but we still have the advantage. By train, we can reach the Romanian port at Varna in 3 days. By ship, it will take him at least a week. From Paris, we travel through the Alps to Budapest. The Count must sail round the Rock of Gibraltar, where we have posted a lookout, and then on to the Black Sea port at Varna, where we will meet his ship and burn it into the sea.
Noon, Homewood received a wire from his clerk at Lloyd's. The Count's ship sailed past us in the night fog to the northern port of Galatz. The Black Devil is reading Mina's mind.
Varna. Galatz. It's about 200 miles. I think that with the horses we can cut him off, reach him before he reaches the castle. I will dispatch Van Helsing straight for Borgo Pass. If we fail in our task, you will have to finish him. From Varna, Mina and Van Helsing took a carriage, and we continued on the train towards Galatz, where we still hoped to intercept the Count before he reaches land. I am fearful for Mina. She is now our decoy.